welcome back to Emily News at 11:30 p.m. We finally got to the p.m.s, y'all. Thank you so much for all the support that you've given Emily News. Well, thank you for joining us today at Emily News. This is Emily News, and I'm your host, Emily. If you want some more information about the news that we are going to show today, you can go to emilynews.com. That's emilynews.com. And you can also pay us. And what do you get in return? The news. Now on to big news / trending news with Kinley. Kinley, what's the big news / trending news today?
Yes, hello, this is Kinley with the big news / trending news. And today's big news / trending news today is these new shoes by the brand Soda. They're so soft and so comfy, and feels so great. These are the shoes you want, and they also make you a little bit taller because they have like a little stump. They're so plushy, and they can stretch, and they're soft. And they come in this color, which is like a taupe pink kind of color, and they also come in black. These are the shoes you need, and this is the big news / trending news today. Back to you, Emily.
Wow, Kinley, thank you so much for that big news / trending news. Now on to Lily on the Spot. Lily, what spot are you on today?
Yes, hello, it's Lily on the Spot, and today I'm on an orange spot. Back to you, Emily.
Wow, that's awesome, she's on an orange spot today. Well, now on to Ginger Scores with Sports Updates. Ginger, what you doing?
Yes, hello, this is Ginger Scores with your sports updates. Today we're going to be talking about how the Saints got that W and the Ravens got that L. Because the Ravens missed like their first field goal in like 360 games or whatever. Or maybe it was like 360 field goals. I don't know. But they have been making like a lot of field goals in a row. Like a bunch of like consecutive field goals. And at the Saints game, if they would have made that field goal, they would have won, but they missed it. So, the Saints won, and I'm repping the Saints with my jersey. Ooh, 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 ooh. I love the Saints, and I'm so happy that they won. Sorry, Ravens, but if you would have made that field goal, you would have won. Well, you would have tied it, so who knows if y'all would have won. We had a better chance of winning, though, because we're awesome. We're Saints. Boom, boom, boom. Let's go, Nola. Woo! Back to you, Emily.
Thank you so much, Ginger, for the sports updates that we have finally, that we've always gotten every week. These were just so great. Well, can't really tell what the weather is, but I'm sure we all know what it is, because sunshine, Susie's gonna tell us what it is, and it'd be a shocker if it wasn't.
Sunshiny as always. Back to you, Emily.
As always. This has been a lot of segments, and I'm sure you want a little break. So, on to one of our most liked subjects in our new show, The Commercial. We'll be right back.
Have you ever been in that group project and your group project doesn't have any pizzazz? Have you ever been in that group project and you just need some color to pop it out? We have the product for you. The product you need. The product to give you that pizzazz and give you that pop of color. You know what it is. Puff balls. It gives you all the pizzazz you need. It comes in sizes small, medium, large, and extra large. comes in many different colors.
We even have a bag here for you.
They're so fluffy. Wow, that's fluffy. It's what you need. Trust me. You'll know when you get them.
Puff ball. Ba-bum.
Wow, puff balls sound so amazing. Well, we're almost out of time, but I think we have time for cookout cook time. Yes, so here's cookout cook time with Carly. Oh, dagnabbit, we're out of time again. Looks like we were a little off on the time. Sorry about that, Carly. Well, thank you guys so much for watching Emily News at 11:30 p.m. today. Almost at a.m., but we're in the p.m.s now. Whoop, whoop. So I hope to see y'all next time. But that's all for today's Emily News. Until next time, see you later. 'Cause we kind of got the time mixed up a little bit. But thank you guys so much for watching Emily News at 11:38. Oh, dagnabbit, we're out of time today.
You'll know when you get them. Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you 5 DIY last minute Halloween costumes because it's Halloween Eve. Tomorrow's Halloween and I don't even know what I'm going to be. But thank goodness I have these 5 ideas and I can hopefully dress up as one of them. If you don't have a costume idea, this is a video for you. And if you like this video, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below if you're going to use any of these ideas. And subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's get on to the 5 DIY last minute Halloween costumes.
For this costume, I have a blue and white checkered dress, which has white flowers on it and white embroidery on it. And then paired with this, I have some red accessories for the braids. Can you guess what it is? And then I have just some comfy white Adidas to pair with it. And then this next accessory will definitely give you what the costume is. Yep, it's red slippers on a bracelet. Yep, that's right. This is my Dorothy from Wizard of Oz DIY last minute Halloween costume. And also, if you don't have a basket, you can just use your trunk or treat bucket, and that can just be used as your basket. And that's the Dorothy costume. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. Yep, that's right. Here's my Dorothy DIY last minute Halloween costume. I have my hair in braids with red ponytails. And then I have my blue and white checkered dress on with my white Adidas. And then here I have my bracelet with the red slippers on them because there's no place like home. Click, click, click. And then I have my blue bucket. And if you want to make this outfit even more special, you can also get a dog. For this costume, I have a hot pink long sleeve shirt, and I paired this shirt with just some regular black leggings, as you can see right here, and then paired with this shirt and these leggings, I have my white high top Converse, because it definitely matches the outfit. Ta-da! They're not really white, but it matches with the outfit theme. Then you can choose any scrunchie of your choosing. Here's a bunch of different colors. And then I have my hoop earrings. Yep, this is my 80s last minute Halloween DIY costume. Just beat it. Just beat it. Bum, bum. Bam. Yep, that's right. Welcome to the 80s, y'all. And it's the 80s last minute DIY Halloween costume. First, I have this hot pink top that you just saw, paired with my black leggings, my high top, white Converse, and then, of course, who can forget their poofy big hair? Yeah, that's right. I have my hair teased up into a side high ponytail with my hoop earrings, and my scrunchie is in my ponytail. And that's my 80s DIY last minute Halloween costume. For this costume, I have a black Adidas shirt with my black Adidas pants, so all comfy clothes. And then paired with that, I have these really comfy pink taupe kind of shoe colored. They're super soft, super comfortable to wear just any day. Then I have my neck plushy pillow thing, and it's so, so comfortable, especially on a plane, hint, hint. And then I have a blanket that I got on an airplane, hint, hint. And then I have a travel bag for when you get on the airplane. Yep, that's right, this is my airplane DIY last minute Halloween costume. It's early in the morning, and I'm traveling. Yep, I'm getting on an airplane. And this is my outfit for getting on an airplane. First of all, I have my neck plushy, like, pillow thing, and I have my hair in a sloppy bun because who cares when they're getting on a plane. And I wear contacts, so if I got on an airplane, I'd wear my glasses, so that's what I'm wearing, but this is optional. Then I also have my airplane blanket with me, as you can see, for when it gets cold on the plane. And then I have my comfy t-shirt and pants from Adidas with my boom! Really cute shoes on that are super comfortable. And then I have my travel bag with me. And that is my airplane DIY last minute Halloween costume. For this costume, it's the hot or cold costume. And I picked out for the hot costume a tank top, athletic shorts, and some Birkenstocks. That way it looks like you're like hot outside. This costume is recommended for people who live in towns that are going to be, like, hot on Halloween. On the other hand, if your town's going to be, like, let's say, freezing cold, then you can pretend like you're in the snow, and you can wear things such as a fluffy pullover with any shirt underneath, jeans, some boots, a CC hat, and mittens. And this is the hot or cold DIY last-minute Halloween costume. I feel it hot, 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 but this costume, you're really gonna be hot because you're being hot. And I have my tank top and my athletic shorts and my shoes that are Birkenstocks to make it look like I'm burning up. And then I also added some sunglasses and my hair in a sloppy bun to add more to the hot effect. Did someone say Halloween? I think it's more like Christmas. This Halloween's cool, but it's a little too cool. Just kidding. But this is also a great costume because people could walk up and they could be like, "Hey, it's not cold outside. Are you cold?" And then you'd be like, "No, it's my costume." And then they'll be like, "Ha, that's funny." And then you'll be like, "I know." And then you'll laugh, and it'll be funny. But I have my CC hat, I have my mittens on, my fluffy jacket, my jeans, and my fluffy boots to rock this awesome, cool outfit. No pun intended. But it's actually pretty hot. Yeah.
Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button, comment down below which, costume was your favorite. I don't know which one was my favorite. Maybe the airplane one, just because I got to dress up all, like, you know, comfy. But subscribe to my channel, turn the button from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. I post every single Saturday, and I sometimes post bonus videos like this one. Also, after this video, make sure to click the button over here and over here to watch other videos, and click the circle in the middle to subscribe to my channel. That's all for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing Q&A number 3. But before we get on the video, make sure to press that like button, comment down below what other videos you'd like to see, and subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to gray and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's get on to the Q&A. Are you named after anybody? I am named after my mom. My middle name is the same as my mom's. What's your eye color? My eye color is brown, green.
So it's brownish, greenish. It's hazel. That's what it is. Summer or winter? I'd say summer because we're out of school, but we're also out of school like for summer winter. I'm going to say winter because I have more to do in winter, and summer sometimes I just don't have anything to do. So I'd say winter because I have my birthday, Christmas, New Year's Eve, all that fun stuff. So definitely winter. Are you dating anyone right now? I am currently not dating anybody right now. What is your favorite cereal? My favorite cereal, I have two. It's either Cocoa Pebbles or Fruit Loops. One of those. What do you want to do when you grow up? So what job? I want to be an optometrist, which is an eye doctor who's special and like they like do contacts and glasses. So yeah. What is the first thing you instantly notice about people? I notice how they smile. I don't know why I like that. I like to see how people smile. It's just something that I do. Computer or television? I'd have to say computer just because I don't really watch TV at all. Sometimes I'll watch football games or a TV show that comes on or like a Hallmark movie, but other than that, I'm usually not on TV a lot, so I'm more on the computer. How old are you? I am currently 13 years old. What are your favorite scents? My favorite scents are Warm Vanilla Sugar and A Thousand Wishes. That's my two from like Bath and Body Works, but other than that, if I'm just going for just a scent in general, it'd probably be cinnamon. Do you have any special talents? Not really. I have normal talents. Last question. What is probably the hardest thing you've ever like had to give up? Why is it hard? Why was it hard to give up? So about a week ago, I gave up social media besides YouTube. I gave up Instagram and Snapchat, which were the social medias that I were on, and I decided to give them up, and it was actually pretty hard to give up Instagram, not so much Snapchat, it's just because I haven't been on it that long, but I have been on Instagram for about 2 years, and it was hard because I was pretty addicted to it, but now I like being off of social media because I feel like not as stressed. And that's the end of the Q&A. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what other videos you'd like to see. And subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to gray. And click the bell to get notified when I post a video. That's all for today. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing Things I Wish Didn't Happen to Me Part 2. If you want to see Part 1, then you can click the I button located over here. And before you get off the video, make sure to press that like button, comment down below what things happened to you that you wish didn't happen, and subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's get on to the video. Alright, I got our project.
We had a project due today?
Yeah, I totally forgot to do it.
Thank goodness I did your part.
Where's the other people that are in our group?
Yeah, about that. I texted them this morning and they said that they were going to the mall, so they're not here.
They're not here, of course.
Y'all better be glad I did all the work in this project.
I knew this was gonna happen.
Alright, if I throw an 8, I'll win the game.
That's a 9.
You did not win the game. I did.
What?
You're kidding. You're kidding. What are you
trying to do? Good morning, students. I hope you had a great night last night. Especially since the major grade was your homework last night. So if you didn't do it, you failed.
Yes, and then she came over and she was like talking smack to me. And basically I just tried to tell her that, you know, you need to be a little bit nicer and all. But, you know, that's just how it is.
Alright, I gotta go.
Bye.
Alright, bye.
Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what things you that happened to you in this video. The things that happened in this video that happened to you. And subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to green, click the bell, you're notified when I post a video. That's all for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing my nail polish haul. I'm just going to be showing you all the nail polishes that I have. And before we get on to the video, make sure to press that like button, comment down below what your favorite color nail polish is, and subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's get on to the nail polish haul. So I'm going to be showing you in color order. So first off, I'm going to show three, and they're all different, but it's because I have four sections of colors that are all the same, and then I have these that don't have a section. Anyway, I have, first off, this white by OPI. I have a brownish, it kind of has like a little red tint to it, but it's mostly brown, and it's by Pixel. And then I have this mint green by OPI. So these are the first three of the nail polish. Next up, I have all my reds. So first of all, I have this really, really, really dark red. It doesn't look red, but it's very, very dark. But when you put it on your nails, it's kind of like really shiny, and it looks really thin, but in here it just looks like not red. But it is by Sally Hansen, so that's that. Then I have this just regular red by OPI. Then I have a darker red by OPI. And then I have this, it's called Cherry, and it's by Sweet Tarts. I don't think it smells like it. I think it's just supposed to like the look, like supposed to look like it. Yeah, it doesn't smell like cherries. But that is all my reds. Next up is my blue collection. So first off, I have, it's in like an ice cream cone shape, and I really don't know what the brand is of this, but it's just a light, shiny blue. And it looks like it's supposed to look like an ice cream cone, but I do not know what the brand is. Then, just like the red one, I have Blue Punch, and it's from Sweet Tarts as well. But it's named Blue Punch. I doubt it smells like it. I really don't want to smell it, because that one did not smell good. No. Okay, I thought it smelled like a little something, but no. But it's just a little bit darker than the ice cream cone one. Then I have another Sally Hansen. Dark blue. This used to be like one of my favorites to just put on my toenails. I really liked it. But yeah, it's a dark blue. And the last one is by Clean Color. It's about the same as the Sally Hansen. It's just a dark blue. So yes, that is all of my blues. Next up, I have my purple collection. So first off, I have, again, another ice cream cone. Still don't know what the brand is. This is just a light shiny purple. And oops, I don't know what the brand is. Then I have this super, 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 super dark purple. I don't even know. Oh, it's OPI. I couldn't see. But when you put it on, it's like the dark red. Like it's like pretty thin, and you can like see it's lighter. But in here, it looks really dark. But when it's outside, it's pretty light. Next, I have another OPI. It's a lighter purple, though. So, looks a lot lighter. And then this is, like, one of my favorites. It was in one of my favorites videos. My favorite nail polish. It's a light purple by Essie. This is the only Essie nail polish I have. And I love it so much. So great. And, yeah. So this is all of my purples. Lastly, I have my pink collection, a bunch of pinks. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So first one is kind of like a hot pink, but it's by OPI. So there it is. Nextly, it's kind of purplish, but I think it's more on the pink side when it's on your nails. It's by Sinful Colors, and it's kind of like a sparkly, like I said, pinkish purple, but it's more on the pink side. Next, I have another OPI, and it's kind of a really light pink, but it looks a little bit darker on your nails. Next, I have the third ice cream cone. It's a light pink sparkly by the ice cream people. And then the final ice cream cone, it's a darker sparkly pink. So I had a purple blue and then two pinks. Next up, I have just this pink, hot pink nail polish. I think I got this from Justice. It doesn't say that, but I think I got it from Justice, but it says nail polish on there, so who knows. But it's not sparkly, but the lid is. The next one is my last OPI. It's a sparkly light pink, kind of like this ice cream cone. They kind of have a little similarity to them, but that's that. And then next up, I have a glow-in-the-dark nail polish. Don't know the brand on this one either. But it's supposed to light up, and I tested it the other day or something to see if it still works, and it does. It still works, and I've had it for a few years now, but it still works, so it's glow-in-the-dark, a light pink. And then the last nail polish I have is by Colorstay Gel Envy Revlon, and it's a light pink. I love this color. It's like the Essie Purple, but it's like pink, and I love this color. And I don't know if I can remember this. Here's all my pinks. My scoop. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what other videos you'd like to see. And subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to green. Click the bell to get notified when I post a video. That's all for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Why am I doing this? Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be reacting to my old Musical.lys, and this is when it was originally Musical.ly. I had an account. I deleted it after a little bit, but I finally found it. I downloaded TikTok yesterday because I thought this would be a fun video, and so I found my old account, and I'm going to be looking at some old videos. I actually have like over 1,000 followers. I'm very surprised, but I'm very scared to see these Musical.lys because they were from a long time ago when I thought, like, you know, whipping and dabbing with school or whatever. But before we get on to the video, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what other videos you'd like to see. And subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to green. Click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now, let's react to my old Musical.lys. Yay. Okay, so this is my account over here. I'm going to try to show the video. Let me just get over some so you can see. Okay, so this is the video, and I'm going to react over here. So this is the last video I did. I did say my moves were a little bit off, but you know, it's fine. I remember I was very proud of this one right here. The full load. But I don't remember why I really deleted Musical.ly. I don't really know. That's not a payphone. It's still like just weird because none of these looking now are like good. I don't know what this is, but this camera quality, it's nice. Alright, the next ones are going to be some from around Christmas time. This one is... It's good old days. I didn't see I'm like wearing like reindeer stuff. So it's around Christmas. I guess I didn't do any Christmas songs. I'm scared to watch this. What is this?
But you think you know me? you don't even know me. Margaret, we're twins. We've lived together for 20 years. Okay, maybe you think you know me. You don't even know me.
What is this?
Oh my gosh. I got another account.
With no content? It's private, and I can't accept my own photograph now. Okay. I look really good in this picture. That's just because Snapchat, thanks to Snapchat. I mean, without Snapchat, it would not have happened. What is this? My hair, like, you can tell I just got, like, out of the shower or something. Like, my hair is, like, wet. You can tell it's wet. I forgot the words. Yeah, I'm not watching that. Okay, these are some Musical.ly's I did when we went to the Saints game a few years ago. Look how long my hair. I look like JoJo Siwa with my hair. I don't know. What is this? Water bottle flipping. Oh, great. Because we all loved that. Boom. 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 Yes. 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 And there's my dad. Yes. 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 That made a loud noise. I remember that. The bathroom's blue. In my last video, my nail polish haul, my bathroom is yellow. It was blue in that Musical.ly. It's awesome. What's this? Let Me Love You by Justin Bieber. I can skip out on that for now. I don't want to watch any of these. What is this? Jump Shot. Those dance moves. Those are good dance moves. How to react to this kind of stuff. I don't know.
I believe I can't fly. I believe I can't fly!
I used to think that I could not.
I really don't know what that is. I don't know what this is.
All these days I never thought that I would need someone so much you knew.
Why it's upside down, I don't know. That's just, who knows.
Knock, knock. Who is there? Knock, knock. Who's there? Knock, knock. I gotta squeeze you to get the
I didn't know the words.
Knock, knock.
This is all before my YouTube days. Yeah. What am I doing? Those headphones. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below if you want to see more videos like this, or if you want me to react to more Musical.ly's, and subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to gray and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now, I was about to say let's go to the video, but that's all for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing my November favorites. It's finally December, so it's finally Christmas time. As you can see, I already have some decorations up, and I have decorations located all around my room. I've already decorated my room for Christmas, besides my Christmas tree, so I'm really excited for that. But today I'm going to be showing you my November favorites, the things I loved in November. But before we get onto the video, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what your favorite month is of the year, and if you're excited for Christmas. And subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's get on to my November favorites. First up is my favorite food, and this month it was actually a food that I did not have this month at all, and I haven't had for a while, but it was catfish. I don't know, I just wanted catfish so much this month, so I made it my favorite food. I love catfish. I like begged my mom and dad to go to a place to get catfish, but they're either closed because they're open on different days, or it's too expensive, so I can't get it. But that's just what I've been craving lately, so I put that as my favorite food for November. Next up is my favorite drink, and my favorite drink this month was sweet tea. And yeah, that's it. Next up is my favorite makeup slash like product I put on my face. And for this month, it was Aquafina Flavor Splash Berry Zoco. I'll show it to you here. Yes, it's Berry Zoco. That's the scent or flavor or whatever. But it's like strawberry. That's what it smells like. But it really is a lip balm, and it really hydrates your lips, and I really love it. I love EOS, but this is definitely really close to EOS, so this is my favorite thing for November for makeup. Next up is my favorite nail polish, and for this month it was this light pink that you saw in my nail polish haul, which was like a few videos ago, like two, and this is called Card Shark. It's number 100, but it's just a light pink, and it's super pretty, so this was my favorite for November. Next up is my favorite Bath & Body Works product for November, and I actually got this like a week or two ago, so I didn't have it the whole November month, but it's called Champagne Toast. It's one of the Germex, but it smells super good. I don't know if it smells like what champagne smells like. I have no idea, but it smells really good. That's what it looks like. Super cute picture on the front. Super good smell, love it. So this was my favorite Bath & Body Works product of the month. Next up is my favorite shoes for the month. And my favorite shoes this month were these Madden Girl shoes. And they are gray. They kind of look blue in like real life. They kind of have like a blue tint, but they're gray, dark gray. They're super cute, super comfortable. They did give me a blister, so I do have to wear some socks with them. But other than that, they were my favorite shoes of the month. I really loved them. They give me some height. And I need some because I'm only like 5'1.5". But they're super cute, super comfortable with socks on. But yes, I loved these shoes. They are by Steve Madden, but it's Madden Girl. So it might be by his wife. I don't know. But it's called Madden Girl. So I'm pretty sure it has something to do with Steve Madden. So that's my favorite shoes for the month. Next up is my favorite TV show. My favorite TV show this month was Dance Moms. I don't know why, I just kind of started like binge watching some episodes, and that was my favorite TV show this month. So, as always, my favorite music is Christian contemporary, but this month it's Christian contemporary music and Christmas music, since I've been listening to Holly lately. So my favorite Christian song this month is Tremble by Mosaic MSC, and then my favorite Holly song, or favorite Christmas song, has been anything by Pentatonix, honestly. There are so many different songs that I love, but I think probably my favorite by Pentatonix would be That's Christmas to Me, you know? Yeah, that song. I don't know. Next up is my favorite shirt, and for this month it was this long sleeve pink white polo shirt. It's super comfortable. I've worn it a few times, but I like how it's like flowy, so it like kind of like, it's like mermaid dresses, like they're like, and then they pop out. That's kind of how it is at the bottom. If you can see, it kind of like flares out at the bottom, and it has a high low, which I like, so it's lower in the front than the back. But it's a super cute shirt, super comfortable. But yeah, that was my favorite shirt for the month.
Next up is my favorite Sunday clothing, and for this one it's just a shirt, so I would wear pants with it, but the shirt is brown, and I like the design. Like, if you can see the bottom, it's like it, on my body it would like go up, but it's more like down here, so it does cover, but it has a cute pocket, super, super, super soft, very nice material. It's by, if you can see that, it's by that brand. But it's a super cute shirt. I hadn't worn it before this month, like ever, but it's super soft and is my favorite Sunday clothing for the month. Next up is my favorite piece of jewelry for the month, and for this month, it's kind of like jewelry, not fancy, but it's one of these bracelets, you know, that doesn't make like indents in your hair. But it's like black and white, like marbly kind of. It's more like white, whitish gray, like a darker white, like a grayish hint to it with black polka dots. But it's really cute. It goes with a lot of stuff, and that's my favorite accessory slash jewelry of the month. And lastly, one of my favorites to do in my favorites video is my favorite item in my room. And since I started decorating for Christmas during the month of November, my favorite item in my room is Christmas themed. It's like Jesus, baby Jesus in a manger with an angel, and it's on the word joy, and it has like the star and a little sheep or a lamb, and I just thought it was super cute. I put this in my room every year, and I have for as long as I can remember, but it's super cute, so this is my favorite item in my room for November. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what your favorite thing was that I showed you today. And subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to gray. And click the bell to get notified when I post a video. That's all for today. And I'll see you guys next time.
Hey guys, it's day two in Houston, and I'm in my cousin's house right now. This is where we stayed. Basically, you're probably wondering why we're in Houston, and that's because we're going to a Texans game today. It's gonna be really fun. One of the players on the team is from the town that we grew up in the town that we live in, so it's really special that basically our whole town's coming to see him play today, but that's what we're doing today. I'm gonna probably film more of me today. It's not just gonna be traveling today. So if you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to green. Click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's go to the Texans game.
I lost it. We lost, so now
and
we got
to... lost and you lost? We all lost.
No, we lost. And we're going back to the car, and then we're going to go home. So, yep.
What do I think about during the Christmas season? Well,
dear Santa, it's that time of year again, and it's time to get your favorite letter from your favorite little girl. And your favorite kid in general, honestly. Alright, here's what I want for Christmas this year. A new scooter. Because mine's blue, and I like pink. I also need a new notebook. This is my last paper to write Dear Santa letters on. And what am I supposed to do next year? And what am I supposed to do after you give me all these things? I have to write you a thank you letter. Last thing. I need some really good crayons. Because Mikkel, he stole my crayons while I was using them. And he laughed at me. And now I only have 59 crayons, and I was supposed to have 60. So I need like a whole new crayon box. Well, that's all for today, Santa. Love, your favorite. Yes, this is Emily. All right. Time to send the letter.
Ha. I want to know what I'm getting for Christmas, so of course I can't unwrap it because I don't know why I wrapped it. So my method is the shaky, shaky, shaky. Nothing really to shake. What? They're all shake proof. Okay, this is my last present. No! There has to be one more.
There has to be one more somewhere.
No. There's no more for me.
What do I think about during the Christmas season? Well, of course I'm writing letters to Santa. And of course I'm asking him for things. And mostly, well, there's a lot of things that I want. Let me name a few for you. I want a scooter. I want some new crayons. I want a new stuffed animal. I want some new light fixtures in my room because these are like so like not bright. And I want a new angel for the top of my tree. And I want a new door handle because mine's gold. And gold is like so out of style. And I want a new pineapple to go in my room. I want a new picture frame. I want some more earrings. And I want a new bedsheet. And
all right, now that I'm a preteen, there's no more writing letters to Santa. Please, that's so like last year. This year, I'm just writing down my Christmas list. Maybe I'll deliver it to Santa, but I'm not writing him a letter. I'm basically just telling him what I want, which is the new iPad Pro. The new iPad Pro is so, so in style, and I'd be so popular. Next, I need the new iPhone XR. Really, I want blue, but if I don't get blue and I get like yellow or orange, It'd be okay. But it really won't blue.
What do I think about during Christmas? Well, I know that Santa can't bring me all of the 30 electronic devices that I asked for this year. I mean, it's kind of unrealistic. I mean, it's possible, but I need to take some matters in my own hands. So I go to my most reliable resource, Amazon.com. And I buy about 2 electronic devices, and then I mostly count on Santa to bring the other like 25 to 28, because it changes every year. In the past few years, he's only brought me about 1. Well, 0 to 1. But I really think I can count on Santa this year. I'm getting older, and I don't know. We'll have to see. I'm not writing him any letters, which means he doesn't have to read anything. So I'm saving him time. So I think he's going to give me a lot of electronics this year, which is what I love.
I don't want Christmas.
Honey, where have you been?
Asleep.
Honey, it's Christmas. Why are you being such a Grinch?
Because it's 8:30 in the morning. I got about like 5 more hours of sleep to go. So let's hurry this up.
Oh, wow. 1,000 wishes lotion. 1,000 wishes fragrance mist. And 1,000 wishes hand sanitizer. Thanks. Oh, that's all my gifts. All right, bye.
Think about during the Christmas holidays? Well, obviously partying, because it's my nature, but also picking out the perfect outfit, which I obviously did. This is so in this year, especially for Christmas. It's like all coming back. And of course that perfect New Year's kiss, because once it's Christmas, it's only 1 week away until that little smooch comes along. So I have 1 week to find the perfect guy, but I'm sure I'll find him at some Christmas party.
My sister wants a new Christmas decoration. That's cute. How much is it? $20. I'm on a kind of a short budget, so we'll come back to that.
The books. All right. The children want books, which is good. They need books. They wanted Christmas books. I'll get them one each, you know. There's The Story of Christmas, The Night Before Christmas, My First Christmas, My Christmas with Jesus, Mary and the Manger. These are all good books. These seem really nice. And there's The Rainbow Fish, and The Very Busy Spider, and Good Night Moon. I think I can find me some books here for the children. What do I think about during Christmas? Well, obviously, I have to spy on the kids, because if I buy the wrong Christmas present, I'll go down on the parent list, and I might become lower than their dad. And mom's always gotta stay on top, so of course I have to spy on the kids to make sure I get exactly what they want for Christmas. Speaking of Christmas, it has to be perfect. I mean, Christmas is that time of year where there's cheers, and there's laughter, and there's presents. But it's so stressful when I'm trying to make the perfect Christmas out for my family and it does not work out. Mostly because of my mother-in-law, because she has to critique every single thing I do with my cooking and the way I dress and how I go shopping for my children. And of course she's always asked me,
what do the children want this year? And I can't tell her because what if she buys something that maybe they want more than the gift I have? I have to be on top.
Oh my goodness, look at the grandchildren. They were so little back there. Yes, you were. Oh, so cute.
I look really good in that one.
I guess some things never change.
Thank you so much, sweetie, for helping me make the Christmas dinner this year. It's gonna be so good. I think because you're helping me, you're moving up on the grandchild pyramid. Ain't that right?
What do I think about during the Christmas season? Well, first of all, I make the most scrumptious food for the Christmas meal. Everybody comes over to my house and we all sit around the big, big table which fits 30 people. And we all eat, and we all talk, which is something not a lot of people do these days. We talk, and we get to know about what people have been doing since we've seen each other, which is Thanksgiving, which is when we go to my daughter-in-law's house. She can't fit as many people as me. Anyway, her children, my grandchildren. I'm tearing up just thinking about them. They're so sweet. Of course, since I'm the grandma, I spoil them. But nowadays, all they want is these electronicas. Yeah, electronics stuff. Yeah, that the A-phone or something. They want all those things, and I can't give it to them. I don't got that money. I spend all my money on food. I love to make food. So good. So good.
I don't remember taking that one. He does not look good.
I just want to thank y'all so much for watching the video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Yeah, I'm taking over. Grandma's in the house. Subscribe to this channel and comment down below if you want to see more of these characters. I know you want to see me. I'm this grandma out here. Yep. Also, click the bell. You know, ding ding. Click that. And you'll get notified when Emily posts a new video every single Saturday. Plus some bonus videos. And there's a bonus video coming up this week. So stay tuned. That's all for today. And I hope to see y'all again soon. Bye. Bye now. Am I done?
Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing my room tour, but it's Christmas-themed room tour. But before we get onto the video, make sure to press that like button, comment down below if you're excited for Christmas, and subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to green, click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's get on to the Christmas-themed room tour. Starting over here, there's just one thing over here that's Christmas-themed, and it's this countdown, which is on the back of my door, and currently it's 15 days until Christmas when I film this, but I'm super excited because it's 15 days till Christmas, and when I post this video, it'll be like sooner than 15 days, so super exciting, but this is just a little countdown that I got from my grandmother, so yeah. Also over here by my dog, I usually have like a puppy dog face mask, like for sleeping, what is it called? I don't know. Sleep mask, I'm just gonna say. I usually have that on the side of my bed, but I changed it to a Christmas themed one, and it just had like snowmen on it and all of that. And now let's move on this way. Moving over here on my TV stand, I'll show you in a second what's up there, but over here I have my Christmas tree, obviously, and it's has an angel on top that lights up, and then I have a white Christmas tree, and this year I kind of went with a little theme of like silver, blue, and white. So that's the color of my ornaments. They're blue, they're silver, there's white down there. I have some presents on here that are blue and white and silver,
And it's just a great Christmas tree. I love it. And yeah, let's move on over here.
Over here, I have my Bath & Body Works products, but over here, I have this little snowman, and it's holding a little white Christmas tree. So yeah, and that's the only Christmas thing over here besides my new Christmas germettes, which is these two. I got Fa La La Latte and Merry Cookie. So that's the Christmas things over here. Now let's move on to this side of the room.
Before we move on to over there, I'm going to show you the other things on this side of the room. On my TV stand, I have this other little snowman, which has like little angel wings, and it's also holding a Christmas tree. And then the last thing is a new blanket. Usually I have a blue blanket on my bed, but I changed it to penguins and snowman blanket that I got for Christmas. And yeah, now let's go to that side of the room. Starting over here, first I have this picture frame, and it has our schedule for all our church festivities at Christmas time on here, and it's really good to keep up with it. I'm going to move this out of the way for a second. And then I have my little jewelry box over here. Starting on top, I have this little manger set over here. And then lastly on my jewelry box, I have these light up lights, super festive. And yeah, on to the rest of the desks. Moving over here, I just have one more thing on my dresser, and that is the second manger set, and it says joy on it. I'm pretty sure it was in like one of my favorites video, maybe my November favorites video, but I just love it. It's super cute. And yeah, so that's the last thing on my dresser. Now on to the last thing, which is my desk. First of all, over here I have this tree topper. And this is what used to be on top of my tree, but then I found that and I thought it was super cute, so I put that on there. And then I just put these on top of my candles that are over here, because it really just works over there. And it's just a gold angel, and it just has a little hole from where it's supposed to go on a tree. Super cute. Then I have another manger set, and this is after the last Christmas item in my room. Super cute. I love it. And yeah, so that is the last thing. Super cute. And I actually forgot one more thing. Let's go back over there. Lastly, how could I forget like one of my favorite things in my room? It's my Santa hat, and it's one of those sock monkeys, and it's super cute. So I can just put it on top of my head, and I look like a sock monkey ready for Christmas. So yeah, that's the last thing in my Christmas room tour. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button and comment down below if you're excited for Christmas. And subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to green. Click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing Christmas songs in real life. And this is probably one of my favorite videos that I've filmed for Christmas. But before we get on to the video, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what is your favorite video from Christmas that I have this year, or what other Christmas videos you'd like to see. And subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to gray, and click the bell to get notified when I post a video. Now let's get on to Christmas songs in real life.
I know. I really wish that you were here. Guess I'll have a blue Christmas without you. He'll be so blue just thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me. And when those blue snowflakes start falling, that's when those blue memories start calling. Doing all right with your Christmas of white, while I'll have a blue Christmas. Oh, Christmas tree, oh Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches.
oh, Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There's just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I don't need to hang my stockings there under the fireplace. Santa Claus won't make me happy with a toy on Christmas Day. I just want you for my own. More than you could ever know. Make my wish come true? All I want for Christmas is you, baby.
Yeah, I need you to sign here, here, and here, please.
Hey, sweetie, me and your dad here, here alone, but are you gonna be home for Christmas?
I'll be home for Christmas. You can plan on me. Just, please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas. If only in my dreams.
What was that, honey?
Nothing. I'll be home. I'll be home for Christmas. Santa baby. A 54 convertible too. Light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear. Santa baby. So hurry down the chimney tonight. Think of all the fun I've missed. Think of all the fellas that I haven't kissed. Next year, I could be also good if you'll check off my Christmas list. Santa baby. I want a yacht, and really, that's not a lot. Been an angel all year. Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Love, Emily.
Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what other Christmas videos you'd like to see before Christmas comes, which is tomorrow. And subscribe to my channel, turn that button from red to green, click the bell to get notified when I post a video. That's all for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Merry Christmas! Bye! Hey guys, it's Emily. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be doing my Christmas haul 2018. And again, like I said last year, I'm so thankful for everything that I received this year. And I hope every single one of you had a very Merry Christmas. And without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Starting off with my stocking this year, I've already, like, opened some of these gifts. But first I have Sour Skittles, and there's, like, only, like, 10 in here. I've already eaten like almost the whole bag, but I love Sour Skittles, so I got that from Santa. And then also from Santa, I got sea salt, dark chocolate, caramel, Ghirardelli squares, which I also love, and I also have opened these. But these are so good. These are my favorite Ghirardelli, so I'm super happy I got those from Santa. Next thing I got were these earrings. I'm gonna turn them around. Okay. And I wanted these earrings for so long, and I got them from Santa, and they're so cute, and they go with a lot because they're like white. They're a little off-white, but they still go with a lot of things, so I'm really excited about that. I've already worn them like once, I think. The next thing I got from Santa were these sticker nails, and I love sticker nails. I don't have any on right now, but I'm about to put one of these on. I have blue sparkles and pink sparkles, and they're really, really, really pretty. So yeah, I love these sticker nails. Let's see. And then also, I got two packs of extra gum. I already opened one of the packs and eaten some of it. But I got two packs of extra gum. I got spearmint this year. And the last thing I got in my stocking was an Apple Watch band. And you're probably like, well, why do I need an Apple Watch band unless I have an Apple Watch to go with it? So I got an Apple Watch this year from Santa, so I'm really excited about that. Yeah, I'm just super excited. I've been wanting an Apple Watch. All my family has an Apple Watch, so I've been asking Santa for it this year, and I'm super happy he got it for me. But, yeah, I got the Series 3 rose gold Apple Watch with, like, a pinkish, tannish band. It's called Pink Sand, I believe. And then also I can wear my blue band with it if I wanted to, so I can just wear whatever band I want to. But thank you so much, Santa, for all those gifts. And now I'm going to move on to what my parents and my brother got me. Starting off with my brother and me only got each other about one gift that was pretty cheap, like under $10, I'd say. But he got me Wipeout 2 for the Xbox 360 because this year from my parents, he got an Xbox like 1X or something. And so he gave me his old Xbox and I didn't have many games that I really liked. So he got me this game, which I'm really excited. It's really actually pretty hard. I've already played it, but I really enjoyed that. So there's that. And then from my parents, like I said last year, I get one big gift. This year, I got a Vera Bradley suitcase. And you can barely see me off of it. Okay. So I've been wanting a duffel bag or a suitcase for when I go to like church camps or when we do church festivities or just if we go to camps or just somewhere where I need like something to carry on my clothes because we really don't have a lot of stuff, like a lot of suitcases to carry that unless they're like massive and we have like tiny duffel bags or humongous duffel bags. And so this is a perfect size for all my stuff. It has this small zipper right here. And then it has a bigger zipper here. And it has so much room in it for all my stuff to go in there. So I'm really excited about this. So big thank you to my mom and dad for buying me this suitcase from Bear Bradley. Moving on into my cousins, aunts, uncles, grandparents. So from most of them, I just received some spending cash and some cards. That's from some of my grandparents and one of my cousins and the other set of cousins that I have on my other side of the family. And then my other cousin, him and his wife and their son, which is only one, but they got me a Francesca's gift card. I think I received this from them last year and I spent it like right away. But I'm hoping to take this for my birthday out and just go spend some money and go to Francesca's. So I'm really excited about that. And then from my aunt and uncle, I received just a little goodie bag full of some candies that I enjoy. There's like a marshmallow chocolate cup thing, Twix, Reese's, just some good candy in there. And then lastly, from one of my grandparents, me and my cousin received this from them. Try to get it out without breaking it. It's a mini jewelry box and it has my initial on it, an E. And it's so fun to play with all that. But inside is just a little jewelry box. Super, super pretty. I can put some of my special jewelry in here that I only wear like for fancy occasions because it's super fancy. It's super nice and I loved that. And that's all of my Christmas presents. Thank you guys so much for watching my video today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to press that like button. Comment down below what your favorite gift that you got from Christmas was this year. And subscribe to my channel. Turn that button from red to gray. Click the bell to get notified when I post a video. That's all for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Merry Christmas and have a Happy New Year. Bye!